Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about EMF equation of transformer. So before going to derive the EMF equation of transformer, we should assume some of the notations. So those notations we will use while deriving the EMF equation of transformer. The first we will assume pi is equal to flux, also called magnetic flux. Pi m is equal to maximum value of flux. It is measured in terms of webers. And n1 is equal to number of primary winding turns. N2 is equal to number of secondary winding turns. F is equal to frequency of the supply voltage. It is measured in terms of hertz. And E1 is equal to RMS value of primary induced EMF. It is measured in terms of volts. And E2 is equal to RMS value of secondary induced EMF. It is measured in terms of volts. So next we will see about how it will derive. See next one, from Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, the average EMF induced in each turn is proportional to the average rate of change of flux. So that is equal to average EMF per turn is equal to average rate of the flux. Average rate of the flux is equal to d pi by dt. That is d pi by dt. So d pi by dt means change in flux or change in flux divided by time required for change in flux. That is d pi by dt. So next one, where we are getting maximum flux. So from this figure, so where we are getting the maximum flux, this is one complete cycle, both having positive and negative of cycles. So here 1/4 of this cycle, so we are getting the maximum flux. So according to maximum flux consideration, so d pi by dt we are writing in terms of pi m minus 0 by 1 by 4th of f. It is here. So by simplifying, you will get 4 f pi m Weber per second. That is equal to average EMF per turn. So that is only one turn. So now we will see how RMS value of induced EMF, how we will calculate the form factor. From the form factor, so we are going to calculate the RMS value of induced EMF in primary winding and secondary winding. So first we will see the what is the form factor. The form factor is the ratio of RMS value to average value. So this is the form factor. So if you calculate any sinusoidal waveform, that will be always equal to 1.11. So RMS value of induced EMF per turn is equal to 1.11 into average value. Already average value is equal to 4 f pi m. By multiplying with 1.11, so we will get 4.44 f pi m. So there are n1 number of primary turns, hence the RMS value of induced EMF of primary denoted as E1. So already in principle of operation we have discussed primary number of turns N1 and secondary number of turns N2. So by that, induced EMF in primary winding E1 is equal to, we have to multiply with number of turns N1. N1 into 4.44 f pi m volts. Next, coming to the secondary winding, induced EMF E2 is equal to N2 into 4.44 f pi m volts. So next one, so here by rearranging the terms, so we can write E1 is equal to 4.44 f pi m N1 volt. This is the primary induced EMF in single phase transformer. Coming to the secondary winding, E2 is equal to 4.44 f pi m into volts. So this is about induced EMF equation in transformer. Okay, so next we'll see about various losses occurs in the transformer. So here losses are depends on the efficiency. More losses means the efficiency will be less. So here losses are two types. One is core losses and copper losses. Core losses are again two types. One is hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. Next, copper losses are I square R losses here. So by seeing this classification, so losses are two types. Due to core losses will occur due to winding, that is copper losses will occur, right? So we will see one by one how core losses will occur, how copper losses will occur, right? So core losses can also called iron losses. So these are the constant losses in transformer. Copper losses are due to variable losses. So these losses varies with respect to load. Coming to the core losses are classified into two types, hysteresis and eddy current losses, and occurs due to alternating flux in the transformer core. Because of core flux remains practically constant for all load to 3% from no load to full load, the core losses are practically constant at all loads. So these are the constant losses. So next, so we will see about hysteresis and eddy current losses, how we will minimize these losses. So coming to the hysteresis loss, so due to alternating flux in the transformer core, hysteresis losses will occur, right? So here due to alternating flux in the transformer core, so yeah, some power is required for the continuous reversal of the molecule of magnets. To maintain this reversal of molecules of magnets, some power is required. The power is dissipated in the form of heat is known as hysteresis loss. Hysteresis loss is denoted with WH is equal to P into Bmax on 1.6 F watts. So where Bmax is equal to maximum flux density and F is equal to frequency, where P is equal to constant. So here hysteresis loss depends on maximum flux density and frequency. So coming to the eddy current losses, due to alternating flux in the transformer core, eddy current flows in the core. The power is required to maintain these eddy currents. So those eddy currents we have to maintain. So if you want to maintain this eddy currents, we need some power. This power is dissipated in the form of heat and is called eddy current loss. Eddy current loss. How we are minimizing these losses is, so we need to laminate the core. So we need to laminate the core by using silicon steel varnish. So by that we can reduce the eddy current losses. So eddy current losses are depends on the maximum flux density and frequency. So here eddy current loss WE is equal to Q into Bmax square F square watts. So where Q is constant, already we have seen Bmax is equal to maximum flux density and F is equal to supply frequency. So here core losses we can minimize by using the silicon steel content for the core. So here by using silicon steel content, so we can minimize these losses. Okay, na? So this is about core losses. Next, so we'll see about the copper loss. Copper losses are also called I square R losses. These losses occur due to ohmic resistance in both primary and secondary winding. If R1 and R2 are primary and secondary winding resistance, and I1 and I2 are primary and secondary winding currents respectively, then copper losses is equal to I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. In terms of primary winding, primary resistance is referred to secondary and secondary winding is referred to primary, that is equal to I1 square into R01 here, I2 square into R02 here. Right, so here, so by observing these losses, so these losses are proportional to current square or KVA square. So why? Because these losses occur due to ohmic resistance of both primary and secondary winding. Right, so by reducing the less ohmic resistance of winding, so we can minimize these copper losses. So next one, efficiency. So how we are defining the efficiency is, so due to losses in the transformer, output power of the transformer less than the input power supplied. So efficiency we are denoting with respect to the ratio of output power output to power input. So this is the efficiency formula. Right. So next one, the power output you can write in terms of power input minus total losses, or power input is equal to power output plus total losses. That is equal to power output plus total losses are iron losses and copper losses. So here efficiency output, power output by power output plus PA plus PC also we can write. So next one, output power is equal to V2 into I2 cos phi 2. Cos phi 2 is equal to load power factor. So coming to the transformer supplies load of current I2 and with terminal voltage V2. So that's what here output power is equal to V2 I2 cos phi. So copper losses are I square into R2E. So finally, so what we can write, these losses are the losses efficiency is equal to V2 I2 cos phi 2 divided by V2 I2 cos phi 2 plus PA. PA means iron losses plus I2 square R2E, that is copper losses. So this is the efficiency formula. So next we will see about, so next video we will see about condition for maximum efficiency and some problems based on EMF equation and efficiency. So thank you guys. So please watch this video and give your comments.